Okay, now this is the fourth video, and I've got this, well, I guess it doesn't zoom when I've got it on video. I've got a still life set up. I have one source of light. As you can see, there's a lamp. So everything's really lit from behind. Or from upper to lower, back to front, sort of. So most of the shadows are in the front. Ignore my television next to it. That's not going to be part of the picture. Okay, I've taken a couple of still shots, which I will load onto the group site afterwards. But I want you to notice that the small guitar is bringing this top picture. Okay, I talked to you before about a triangular shape. So you've got the guitar neck coming down, and then you've got this teapot. You go across, you see a book. Go up, you see an angel or a fairy. It's a glass candlestick holder. And there are a lot of folds in the fabric in here that I have draped behind. Draping fabric behind the still life seems to give you more interesting things to show depth and shading than if you just have a blank wall. So you don't end up with your picture looking like it's just floating in space. You'll notice there's, in the foreground, there's some other fabric draping over some boxes that I keep stuff in. My art supplies are everywhere around here, so I keep them in boxes. Anyway, the first thing I've done is I've started a sketch, and well, now that I'm using this piece of paper, I'm going to have to turn a light on behind me. So I won't have just the singular source of light in a minute, because I'm going to reach around here and turn on another light so you can see my paper. I started out with just the single source of light so that I'll give myself something to have shadows. You can see I have positioned the objects on the page. Take your time and try and get the positioning right before you go back and do any kind of shading. You can see I have the guitar, I have the outline of the teapot, the book, and the little glass angel. I've got everything sketched in just roughly where they're supposed to be. It's not perfect yet, okay? Now, I'm going to be working on it with my camera off because I don't have a tripod. I guess we noticed that before. My pictures are kind of shaky. What I want you to do for your homework is, after you've set up your own still life, or use the ones that I'm going to put in the photographs, still photographs, on the Facebook group site, which is linked in the video, in the details below the video, actually, in the text. I'll have the link. Use whatever still life you have. Get your rough sketch started. And spend 5 or 10 minutes shading, putting in some details. Give it the texture and the solidity, so you can tell it's not just floating around in space. You want these objects to have a real anchored effect on the table or box or whatever surface you're sitting them on. You want them to look anchored. You want to have a connected, cohesive study to work with. I've got my new art pencils, but any pencils you have, or other drawing utensils. You can use, if you want to, you can use a ballpoint pen. I'm not teaching you to use a ballpoint pen, but when it comes to shading for pencils, you can smudge and you can erase and you can change things. With ballpoint pen, you're going to be doing more of cross hatching. So I'm not actually hoping to see any ballpoint pen drawings, but draw with whatever utensils you have and get it at least to be a rough sketch and put 5 or 10 minutes of refinement into it. When you're done with that, I hope you will take photographs and share your project. You can take a picture of your still life, like I've done here, and take a picture of your drawing that's a completed drawing, and share them with us on the group site, and we'll talk about it. We'll have a discussion. Okay, thanks a lot. You have fun drawing. Have a lot of fun.